And it goes from talking about how amazing nature is,
general revelation,
to talking about how the thinking and the laws of God are perfect.
And specific revelation,
talking about these are the things that are useful and awesome, and I should absolutely be in this camp. And then it concludes with a classic prayer, which I know many musicians have prayed over the years, which is, oh God, don't let me mess this up. And I think that's also a good prayer that's in there. That's the classic, like, I'm in over my head. I need to do a thing. Given how awesome you are, I just want to not mess it up. And a lot of times, just wanting to participate in that community of belief, in that community, on a band or in whatever.
Or in life, in the world.
Yeah, just wanting to show up and not make it worse is like a basic thing. And sometimes that's where you're at. And I think anybody that's involved in any ministry long enough goes through that same thing, where you kind of like, you have some initial success. So you're like, all right, this is where I'm gonna stick with it. And at some point you realize you're not nearly as talented as you think you are. And mainly if you're really honest with yourself, you realize you've gotten a very forgiving congregation, audience, family, recipients of your ministry have probably been very forgiving or had very low standards, one of the two. And you're realizing that, wow, in order to actually do this, I'd better actually put in the hard work to know what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. That very much is, I think, this psalm in a nutshell of like, given how perfect God is, that even nature runs on like clockwork for him, because of him, I just want to be free from big errors. Like, muddle a note here or there, okay, but like, just keep me from big, nasty errors.
Mm-hmm. The way God handles nature is perfect. It doesn't say nature is perfect because it's fallen, but the way God handles it is perfect. The law of the Lord is perfect, this expression. And then we have us, and we know we're not perfect.
Yep.
And yet,
our sins are ever before us.
Yeah. And there's humility, which is beautiful. If we're honest, we're like afraid that this perfect thing God is doing will be messed up by us, and it often is. And yet, Hebrews chapter 12 describes heaven as the place on this holy hill where the saints are made perfect. And so eventually we become perfected, whatever that means, teleos, complete. And so there's a process of us becoming perfect. I like the resignation at the end of that psalm. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, Lord. If we could just get to that point, then we're going to be okay.
It's funny too that the psalmist uses the word acceptable, and I think sometimes that's like the barrier that's the bar we set for ourselves. I
wish
we could be acceptable at this. There was a time when I wanted to be Jimi Hendrix, and I'm like, I'm going to just do. I want to be the great, and I realized like that's not me. I got two kids. I got two careers. Like.
Yeah,
I'm happy that God made people that can waste 60 hours a week practicing and playing their scales. I'm not that guy.
Yeah. And well, you're also not the guy who's drenching his headband in LSD,
right?
And putting it on his forehead so he can.
I am also not that guy. So, but it's funny how, you know, that one of the song we want to talk about, we should transition to, is Joined Together by The Who, which I had Mystic Rhythms, I think, is a great song because it talks about looking at nature and seeing something way bigger than yourself. And the guy that wrote the one that's going to be the header to the piece is the drummer to the band, Rush. And he is a diehard secular humanist. Amazingly good lyrical writer, but that's as close to a praise song as he ever wrote. In all of the 40 albums, or God only knows how many albums they have, like, it's a lot.
Yeah, there's something out there that's beyond me.
Yeah, and he wrote this one song about how we look at nature and we see something way bigger. And he talks about we suspend our disbelief. And that's him. He's the secular humanist going, I don't believe there's anything out there in my head, but I look at nature and I see there's something out there.
Mm-hmm.
But Joined Together by The Who is the other one I wanted to kind of do. And I had forgotten I wanted to do it. But that command, that song to me is the other half of praise. That's the leader standing up and exhorting, demanding, browbeating the audience into, you will join together with the band. And it also helps that it has that corny jaw harp intro. Cowbell only more so, right? I mean, more cowbell.
And then it has this funky sort of an accent that sounds like a piccolo or something.
Yeah, I think it probably is a piccolo or a flute, yeah, or a penny whistle. My guess is it's a penny whistle, because I think in the video you can see them, they're all playing like these trash little like kid instruments.
Okay.
And the video for that song, there's an old video from the 70s, which is them just standing in the middle of an actual Who audience, like playing the song. And the killer thing about that, the song, is it's driven by the bass line, right? That John Entwistle octave, you know, boom, pow, ba-da-da-da-dum. That bass line is one of the most, and it repeats throughout the whole song. The song doesn't really have chord progressions, but it's all just that riff just drives the whole song. And so it's a really fun tune. And what you said something just a second ago about being perfected. We have the wrong idea about perfected. Perfected doesn't mean I will become angelic and anonymous like everybody. It's the perfection of you. You're still you. Yeah. You're still going to have weird personality quirks and things that annoy you, even in the state of perfection. Mm-hmm. I mean, Jesus is still Jesus. He's still wandering around. Presumably, he still knows how to be a carpenter. He still likes fish. We know that about him. Like, like, I don't know. Like, it's not when that process comes to fruition, just like a good band gels, you hear the personalities. I mean, the Who is four people. It's Keith Moon, the drummer, who is a nutcase.